He knows my name.
This song is called He Knows My Name.
He knows my name.
God knows us by name.
He knows my name. She knows my name. Know how he walks with me. Know how he talks with me. Yeah. Know how he tells me.
I am his own. Belong to no one else but him. You know, my heart is grieving, as a lot of people around the world's heart, some hearts are grieving because of the injustice that was done yesterday in Minnesota. As we watch George Floyd's life being taken away from him, his breath was removed from his body. The breath that God gave him was taken. And you know, and I'm praying that people don't become so bitter and violent that they stoop to the lowness that these police officers did, you know, as they stood by and watched this man die. He cried out for his mama, and he said he could not breathe. But they had no remorse, no feelings of sympathy for this man. They just watched him being murdered. I would like to read something here. And before I read that, I'd like to say that the mayor of Minnesota, he did speak out on this, as a leader should do, you know. The leaders should be the first to step up and say something about this injustice. And sometimes you hear people say, well, that's in the past and all of that. You can't look back. No, this is happening right now, you know. And people are grieving. This was someone's son, brother, nephew, you know. He had family. This was a human being. But I like what J.D. Watson says, and this is called tenderness of spirit. He said, it's much easier to convince a human soul of its natural impurity than to convince it of its natural hardness and utterly destitution of heavenly and divine tenderness of spirit. The very essence of the gospel is divinely imparted a tenderness of and sweetness of spirit. Without this, even the strongest religious life is a misrepresentation of the Christ life. Tenderness of spirit is divine. It is a delicacy of soft and sensible and of a mere gentle makeup of the body and mind, which some people naturally possess. You know, you see people, they're so sweet and so nice and all that. But tenderness of spirit comes from above. That's why we must give our hearts to the Lord and ask God to forgive us. You know, we've been having these meetings, Zoom meetings, and I call it, you know, Lord, we're coming to the altar and letting the Lord just burn out whatever in that soul that shouldn't be there. You know, we call it going to the altar and letting God just burn me up. You know, because sometimes people have some deep-rooted things that's inside them that they don't even realize, they don't even take acknowledge to. You know, that rooted bitterness of prejudice and racism and hatred and jealousy and all of these, and fear, all these things and more, unforgiveness, all these things are in the heart. And that's why Jesus came to die for us, so we wouldn't have to So when we accept him, ask him to forgive us of our sins and wash us, he'll do that. He'll start that process like clay in his hands. He will mold us and shape us and refine us and get that out of us, you know? Because number one, hell was not created for human beings. It was created for Satan, for Lucifer and his angels and the followers. But because of sin and the hardness of so many souls now, that those people are going to. Do you know that hell is enlarging itself? And all this division and all these people who are stirring up all of this division and things like that. You better get it right. You better repent. Turn around from that, you know? That's why, you know, I think about David. He said, create in me a clean heart and a right spirit, you know? And that's my plea today, that you would turn around. If you know you harbored some hatred and some bitterness and all of this prejudice and racism, thinking that you're better than somebody else, get rid of it. They talked about Jesus. They said light on Jesus. They spit on Jesus and said, can any good thing come out of Nazareth, which was Jesus? And that's what people said. Is there any good things can come out of blacks? We're talking about Jesus Christ. Can there any good thing come out of Nazareth? Jesus came out of Nazareth to die for your sin. That man shouldn't have had to die like that. That wasn't nobody's place to take the breath from him that God gave him. I'm not going to say too much on it, but I just encourage you to get all that out of your heart, because one day you're going to have to stand before the Lord. You know, you can't hide behind politics or anything else. Hide behind your mama or your good works or all these good things, all these things that you've done, because there's a king coming and his name is Jesus, and he's coming back. He needs no votes. He's coming back. So get it right. You know, ask God to come into your life. You know, ask him to forgive you, come into your life and show you, you know, the areas in your life that needs to be taken care of, because you cannot, you know, this is just a journey. This is just a portion of life. We're sojourners here. We will stand before the Lord one day, and every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. So choose him today. God bless you. I hope you receive something. Keep praying. Pray for those who are lost. Pray for those who are blind. Because, again, hell is enlarging itself. And we don't want anybody to go there.